Let's analyze how this prototype works. It shows a message when you start the game, and there is an option to make that message not appear again. If you check this box and press OK, the message will not be displayed in the next session. In the corner you have a link to download this prototype. So let's start with the canvas. Here I have two windows. One is the start message, and the other window is the menu. The only interactive elements are this checkbox here, it is this object here in the hierarchy, then the OK button of the window, this game object, and finally this button that belongs to the main menu and that allows the user to restore the defaults, this one here. The rest of the elements are all just decoration. So these interactive elements are gonna operate on this script. It's called menu script and it's assigned to this object, UI scripts. Here you can see it in the inspector. In the script we have two game objects for the start message and the main menu. This allows us to activate them or deactivate whenever we want. We also have a boolean that tells us if we are gonna show the start message, and this string is a name to save the information of this boolean. Let's begin analyzing the functions that are gonna execute the elements. This first function is the one that is gonna execute the toggle object. In that element we have the onValueChanged event defined, in which I place the object that has the script assigned, and then I selected this function, but with dynamic parameter. So when we check the box, it sends true to the function, and when we uncheck it, sends false. I explain this because we also have the static function. Here in this case we will have to mark the option that we want to send to the function, but we are gonna use the dynamic function. This other function is executed by the OK button from the start window. Here we can see it. In the onClick event, I also drag this object with the script and then select that function. And this other function is gonna be called by the restore button. Here we can see that. And here in the start function, we decide if the start window has to be shown or not. Notice that I initialize this boolean variable reading an integer value from the memory. Here I'm using the getInt function from player prefs. This here is the name of the value I want to retrieve, and in case there is no value, because it's the first time the game is started for example, I make the function return 1. As player prefs doesn't have a function to save booleans, you can save a 0 in case of false and a 1 in case of true. So with this instruction we recover an integer value, 0 or 1. We have to convert that value to a boolean, and we can do it comparing it with the value 1. That is, if the memory value gives 1 as result, all this instruction is gonna be equal to true, because 1 is equal to 1. If this gives 0, all this instruction is gonna be false, because 0 is different from 1. And finally, I activate or deactivate the windows depending on the boolean variable. If the start message must be shown, I activate the message window and deactivate the menu. If the message mustn't be shown, I do the opposite. We can summarize all this with these two instructions. When interacting with the toggle element, this function will be executed, with true value if the box is checked, and with false if it doesn't. Then I invert that value and assign it to this variable. The reason I'm inverting the value is simply because of the names I chose for the variables. This variable is called showStartMessage. If it's true, it means that we have to show it. This checkbox instead, when true, means that we should not show the message again. Then to maintain consistency, I invert the variable. Let's analyze the function that executes this button. Here the first thing I do is ask for the status of this variable. If it's false, state in which the variable would be if we check this box, as we see previously. Here what I do is save in memory the zero value under this name, something that then we will interpret as false, and then simply disable the message window and activate the menu window. Finally, the function to restore the default values. An alternative is to delete all the information stored in player prefs, but in this way we could delete information that we don't want to delete. So other alternative is to delete a specific key that is saved in player prefs, simply using the name of the key. Here we execute the delete key function and send the name of the key we want to delete as parameter. Then the next time that the game is started, when we execute this function, there will not be information saved under this name and it will be initialized with 1. That is to say, as if it was the first time that the game is executed. That would be all for this video. I hope you liked it. Remember, you can download the Unity package. Here you have another nice video and a playlist with more solutions. Subscribe and see you next time.
NANI?!